but missed the shot. Murray Martin stop. Pop in and out. Yeah, that was not a good shot. I think he's got to back that ball out.
We'll hear it this way, and that's a travel. Oh, we're going to have a foul before the travel.
Critton will come back into the game, and he will replace Corcoran for the Cougars. What we were talking about earlier, 76.6, that's the team foul season coming into this game, number one in the country for Washington State, and that's better than the Pac-10 record set by USC back in 1976. But they're having a few woes tonight for them.
Yes, we were having
a few woes, is maybe looking four or five, but as I said, when it gets down the last 6-7 minutes, they're going to get the right perimeter people to the line, and they're not going to miss a lot of free throws.
Patrick gets them both and cuts it to six once again.
Now let's see if Martin can come up the floor and redeem himself a little bit. He played well. The last shot he took was not a good one, and he needs now to get the team an offense. McQueen's on the bench. Look for Murray or O'Bannon inside.
They post Murray up. Overplayed. Murray almost made him pay. Followed his own shot in.
Murray is just a monster on the glass. I mean, when he misses a shot, you better put a body on him because he plays a couple of feet over the rim. They wanted a goaltend. They didn't forget the goaltend. I mean, that was good. Definitely was not working.
Lewis steps in, gives it up nicely that time to Critton for the basket. Nice look by Lewis.
Good dribble penetration. But once you get inside with the dribble, UCLA has to try to stop them on the perimeter.
Don't you have a feeling that right now we're in a very pivotal part of this basketball game?
Now you got the feeling right now that the Cougars are going to make a little bit of a run.
O'Bannon off balance through the foul.
And quite frankly, Barry, I'm surprised the McQueen's been out of the game as long as he has. I thought he'd be in a little bit sooner.
There's a look at Don McQueen.
Pinches Don McQueen.
Points tonight. Otto Bannon still playing himself into basketball shape. No problem with the knee. Two operations, of course. One of them very serious operations.
And it was great to see him playing well. You kind of forget that he's a freshman.
Take a timeout. 7:24 remaining. UCLA continues to shoot it very well at the free throw line. They lead it by 8. 71-63.
For about the last 3 minutes here. And Lewis has been quiet the second half. He really has not done much.
But he's picked it up. Derek missed that three. Carver high for the rebound.
There's UCLA now trying to tempo the game a bit. Well, forget that thought.
Tempo it. He's going to take it right to the basket.
Well, maybe they try to use a little bit of the clock to get it. Carver just right to the hoop.
Derek, a little bit of a foul. Carver, who with Ed O'Bannon was headed for UNLV before the screen goes on there.
Of course, the cover's not going to be there at UCLA next year either. I mean, they've got a guy by the name of Richard Petusco who's redshirt and about 6'10", 6'10 and a half. And it'll give UCLA a legitimate back-to-the-basket low-post player. Obviously, they lose McQueen. And they lose Matkins, but they still have a host of players coming back, and UCLA will be there for sure next year.
Now, Patricia, a proven player with Loyola, of course, in that up-tempo game. That is about 18 points a game. Payne, a nice shot down low.
Of course, Martin, another guy that is a senior for UCLA. The Kaya Denny should be the heir apparent to that particular position.
Travel.
It's about time to get McQueen back in the game, I would suspect. Unless there's something wrong with him.
Now here he comes as advertised. Benny Seltzer comes in for Washington State. Don McQueen and Gerald Matkins will come back in for UCLA in a hurry. Derek Martin will sit. And O'Bannon will sit. But O'Bannon gave Jim Harris some good minutes tonight.
Yeah, he has played well. He's come in, made a couple of shots. He played good defense. And conceivably, could be back in this game. All right, it's time right now for the Cougars. Seven down, still a long way to go.
Lewis puts it on the floor. A little scoop shot with the left hand.
Is that pretty?
A little left-handed swivel shot in the lane by Lewis. And he has 14. So Lewis and Derek starting to creep up near their season's average here.
Now really, McClain's only had two in the second half.
Yeah, yeah, he's running. One of five.
Two of six,
yeah. He hurt you. He's got 16 for the game.
Well, he's rested. He's got a little rest, and he's ready to go, and he's analyzed the game, and it was okay. Now I see the openings are. I've been on the bench, and I've watched, and I've committed to be productive.
He's came down low to the basket. All of a sudden, Payne becoming a factor. Cougars get you thinking on the defensive end, because you got to jump out at him and be aware of the three-point shot, and that opens things up down low.
And UCLA playing right behind at the post inside, and Payne's been able to put it away. Critton's made a few shots. So they're trying to put two guys out at the front with Matthews and Carver to split that one defender. Lewis, the only guy at the top defensively. So the Bruins lining up more 2-2-1 against the one-out zone.
Carver, the jump stop. Payne got a hand on that. Butler picks it up underneath. Ball is still loose. Butler gets it back. Tie up, and the possession arrow is UCLA.
Oh, great effort by both teams. They went after that one. I mean, that was a competitive rebound by both clubs, and this shot was blocked. Payne got a piece of it, then a scramble. Butler gets that block. Payne actually gets two blocks consecutively, and then Butler does a smart thing. When the ball's on the ground, dive on the ball. Do not try to pick it up by bending over. Get a brand new shot clock.
Butler cut, and they're going to get Payne for the foul. And Payne might have come knee to knee with Butler, and that's one of those painful injuries.
Yeah, Payne just connected there with Butler, but again, a backdoor play without the ball. They're pressuring me, so what I'm going to do is go the other way, and a good read, and Butler does a nice job to get the ball and draw the contact, and hope Brian Payne is all right, trying to walk it off.
I think that's exactly what happened. I think it was Payne's left knee and Butler's right knee. Class. See if that's what happened.
Yeah, it was knee to knee. Payne seems to be all right. If he's not, he's taking a draw. And Mr. Butler knocks it down.
6-point UCLA lead. Calvin Sampson is not in second. Still virtually fully closed with the
shot. I am really surprised because last week he played Stanford, and he, by this time of the game, I mean, the group was unbuttoned, the tie was long gone.
The only guy that gets his game close is the room.
One of those nationally televised games. He can't afford to make the good and looking sharp throughout the whole ballgame.
That's right. And Jim Zirk, our producer, just reminded me that his dad in the crowd tonight, too, got to look good for dad. Butler took a little shot to the nose under the basket. Oh, his lip. No, he had a cut lip in the deep game. And I think he might have just opened that up again. I think Butler may be in some pain.
All right, now UCLA's used some of the clock. Now they have to try to start the offense. Good pass.
Ooh, just a great effort by Tracy Murray.
Perfect pass by Butler. May have a cut lip. He may be hurt, but still can handle the ball.
He is hurting. See if Jim Harris gets him out of there, he will. He's going to come back with Martin. Butler's in some pain.
Hey, Murray, how did he get that ball up? He was hit, he was bounced, he was on the way down. He still had the presence of mind to get it up on the square and get the ball down.
Mitchell Butler, tough guy. He was cut inside the mouth in the game against Duke. And he was in some pain then, and he's in some pain now.
That's what I call a major upset. Murray missing a free throw in the last 5 minutes. UCLA's open the gap up again, up eight. Two free shots for Washington in the second half, non-existent.
Lewis got the penetration, but couldn't get the shot to go. And McLean clears.
Yeah, big rebound by Don McLean to pick it off.
Good possession here for UCLA now.
Martin has been a much better floor general in the last 4 or 5 minutes. He hasn't looked to score as much, and he's trying to direct the club, and UCLA's been more effective. He can move the ball and not go more one-on-one. Now the goal here, Barry, is to use the clock and then try to start the offense right about now.
And McLean at the baseline, ooh, that's a shot that he is not going to miss very often.
And a master of the baseline, Don McLean, when he gets down on that line, he's tough to stop. And that's a 10-point lead again.
Yeah, and at this point, the Cougars just can't have any empty tricks. Lewis jumps, oh, gets it out, and he goes to the line. That is exactly what Washington State needed.
Maybe the biggest shot of the game for Washington State, just to bring them back and give them a bit of a shot. And Terrence Lewis, playing without the ball, challenges and goes right at Don McClendon. He uses that opposite hand. He uses the right hand to shield, but still got the call.
16 for Lewis now at the line to try to convert the three-point play. Shortly. This is uncharacteristic at the line.
That ends my theory that they're not going to miss a free throw in the last 3 or 4 minutes.
8-point game, man. Now the Bruins can make the clock their ally here, try not to come up empty.
So that's a pretty good move, passing up some shots and going inside out. I still think they wanted something inside. Well, if you had your druthers, you'd rather live or die with Murray or McLean in the paint than Martin shooting a fadeaway.
Shelton bounced it off his foot, picked it up, and just got it back to Derrick, who penetrates, scores, and he goes to the line.
They won't go away, will they?
I mean, you think they're down and out at 10 down, but uh-uh.
First it was Lewis, then it's Derrick. And Jim Harris got to be worried. I mean, here's the play inside. First of all, the recovery on the ground. Another recovery by Derrick. This is dribbled through the whole team. Let's get fouled and make the basket.
What hand from Derrick. And he'll try to convert a three-point play. And he can't.
Well, they were leading the nation in free throws. They may not be after this game.
God, they will.
Good timeout here. This is what you call a regroup adjustment timeout. And Jim Harris, I'm sure, is saying we're going to get the ball inside coming out of this one.
UCLA leads it by 6 with the ball. We'll be back.
Now, got to pick the ball up. I would bet a lot, Barry, in this situation, they're going to end with 45 if they don't turn it over with a shot in the paint from Murray or McClain.
Now, this is absolutely right.
And we'll see. That's one of those times in the game that the shot clock was down to 14. Had you played a little bit more defense, now you're going to force UCLA to try to get something at the end of the 45, which is very difficult because you only have one chance offensively to execute perfectly to get a shot. But he chose to foul Martin.
Yeah, that's exactly what Calvin Johnson is trying to do right now.
Well, UCLA very much the free throw. I think it's a great kick.
Yeah, should UCLA win this game? A really good win for them because there was some question. Even the coaches were wondering how are we going to be tonight following the UCLA loss. Playing on the road, it's a tough place to play. Derrick can't get it to go. And it'll be off of Matkins out of bounds for the Cougars.
Any road win was a very good road win. It was a very good win when you're playing in the conference. But as you said, UCLA, you know, they needed a confidence builder. They needed to get going again, and hopefully for their sake that they can finish the ball.
Shelton puts it in to cut it to 6 again with a minute 33 seconds left. We've got another timeout. UCLA leads it 81-75. They'll have the ball. Jim Harris and Calvin Sampson. They'll talk it over there.
Try to extend the defense and force a turnover. Look to make a quick foul.
Martin says clear up. I'll take it. And which is in foul there.
You can't afford to lock down. You've got to get the quick foul, hope you get a miss and come back. Vincent Russian has stayed there in terms of the NCAA tournament, has a shot to get in, but they're going to have to either come back and win here tonight or beat USC coming in, which is not going to be an easy chance because George Ravlin's club seems to be one of those teams that happen every year that find a way to win games, and they're an excellent ball club, and they're really on an extra, on a roll. So, but if Washington State loses to USC and UCLA, I don't think they're going to get in the tournament.
The fact is, I think Washington State matches up better than UCLA than they do against USC.
You need from a quickness standpoint, I think you may be right because with USC, they're smaller, but they're a speed team. I don't know if anybody can match up with Harold Miner. I mean, he's a real problem to guard. And if he's got it going and he has a big night, I mean, you can forget it.
Back to the way to free throw line.
Now, the one thing you don't want to do if you're UCLA in this situation is foul, stop the clock, and put the Cougars in the free throw line because eventually they're going to start making the free throws.
Only 13 of 21 tonight, and they're well below their season average of 76%.
Now you really need communication offensively, so that you make sure you get the ball in your best free throw shooter's hand. Should they give it a McClain? Hey, McClain's just going to bring it up. Very versatile. See against Clinton, that's a good matchup for UCLA.
They don't want to go get him, but they will go get Martin. He's not a bad free throw shooter either.
Yeah, good move by Martin just to go back and help Tyrone Mathieu off the floor.
Martin, 83% at the free throw line, so even though you don't want to put McClain there, he's 92%, you put an 83% back. January 4th, he's only missed two. Three.
All you got to do is mention it.
It's all that has to be done.
And it's still a two-possession situation for Washington State. I mean, this is a long way from being over.
I mean, this is both.
It was a big play. The Cougars just could not contain the ball. And out of bounds, it will go to the Bruins.
That is a tough, tough break for Washington State.
Martin misses both free throws. And Washington State just can't get it. And Carver has to back that one off.
They got Carver. And he'll go to the line. Well, Carver's a guy that you don't really mind putting there. 61% free throw shooter for the season.
See, this is what you call dead ball counting right here. When utilization and coaching while the ball is not in play. Very important to communicate with your players or with guys on the floor able to say to each other, what are we going to do if we make it? What are we going to do if we miss it? And you always have to be talking to your team, and players have to be talking to each other when the ball is there.
Probably only 1 of 5 at the line tonight, but this is the biggest one he'll shoot. This makes it a free possession game. And Mr. Bogut Murray got a hand on it, but Clinton finally runs it down. Now they'll push it. Hill forced a shot. Not a good shot by Hill.
Surprised it didn't look three coming down the floor. You know there's still time. I think Kelvin Sampson wanted them to look three immediately, but Hill took it straight to the basket. Give UCLA credit, they didn't foul.
That was 48 seconds ago. UCLA tried to help Washington.
Yeah, four in a row.
Watson gets the first one, and that could be it.
Oh, fans will leave it early, and it's still time. Not to give you a total optimist, but there's a lot that can happen in 48 seconds.
And again, Martin takes it all over the basket, and misses a shot. Clinton gets it back for the putback.
Last timeout, I think, because Kelvin Sampson took an early timeout at the beginning of the half, and I believe that's his final timeout. Not not a rule I love in college basketball. I still don't understand why the team that's behind can call a timeout after they make a shot. I understand it's a dead ball transition situation, but still I think that's something they got in any in this ball game. I don't think they turned the ball over like maybe 7 or 8 times in the whole game.
Ooh, that's close to an intentional. But they won't get it at this juncture.
But Jim Harris on the pitch. You gotta be playing the ball when you come up the floor. I mean, you just can't grab the guy.
That was pretty close.
Yeah, that was very close. Clearly, you must go after the ball, not the man. I thought that was more of a cross-body block than Martin when he was coming up.
Martin rattles it in. Hey, Martin's got a nice game tonight.
Yes, he has. And, you know, we were a little bit critical of some outside jumpers, he said, but after that one long one, he has really directed the club well and got himself to the line and played a good ball game, especially the fact that Edney couldn't play. So Martin, a real pivotal player for UCLA.
Foul. Are you kidding? Matson just fouled out. Plays hard. Nice player for Matson.
Yeah, nice guy too.
Yes, he is.
Kelvin Sampson, you know, we were talking earlier today, he was commenting what a nice team he had. I mean, he really loved coaching these guys. They went on a trip during the summer, they went to Russia, played a lot of games, played about 7 or 8 games, and felt the team really came together at that point.
Tyus Edney is going to bring his aching body out to play these final 31 seconds.
Ties a little loose now, it's kind of late. Had this game gone to overtime, it would have been over, though.
It would have all been on. Tyus even walked like he's hit it. They'll miss the free throw. They're getting their hands on the plane, and now you got to follow the 92% free throw shooter.
Obviously, the 10th foul rule didn't detract anybody from making fouls at the end of the game, but when you get the 2 shots, it's a big relief. And you start telling fans they know the choice. You got to look the fouls. The only way you can stop the clock and hope the other team misses a free throw or 2 and give your team the chance to come down and make a 3.
And Matthew fouls out with 6 points. And the Nation's leading free throw shooter will have 2.
Well, a lot of people can learn from McLean the way he shoots them at the line. You notice after he shoots, he always leans forward. You see so many players that shoot free throws and back up. But McLean follows through and goes right at the basket.
He's now on a roll of 32 in a row at the free throw line. So to say that he's not the guy to foul, to make an understatement. Hill for 3. He got a good look that time, but it takes it too little too late.
Big win for UCLA. I mean, this is a real confidence builder for the Bruins, and Washington State's got to regroup and wait for the Trojans to come in here on Sunday.
And they still waited a long time to foul. I know they don't want to foul McLean, but they let enough time to cook off the clock that there's only 7.7 seconds left. And Derek has fouled out also.
You know, regardless of whether Washington State gets in the NCAA tournament or not, I think they've had a fine year. I mean, they've had some quality wins. They played very well in the Rainbow Classic. They had Alabama down in the second half. They've come back, and you know, they didn't start the conference season well. But this is a club that doesn't make the NCAA tournament. I think it'll be a sure NIT team.
And the plan after 32 straight. Glad we got that note.
Yeah, right. Got 32 in a row, huh?
Pull up when he doesn't. Just sitting down low. When he gets a foul on McLean, the clock is stopped. With less than 3 seconds left.
Well, the last 2 minutes does take about 10 minutes to play. And he's going to completely foul everybody when they come down the floor. It extends the game dramatically.
record that statement over 16 minutes for the last two. Okay, 89-85, I doubt whether Washington State's going to use a foul. They may, though. It's quite possible. Well, that's it. 16 is the record. That's it. 16 minutes. And UCLA wins it 89-85. UCLA was never headed. They got out quickly. Washington State just simply didn't shoot it well. One of their first 17. They didn't have a field goal, but for one, the first 8.5 minutes of the ball game. And UCLA goes on and plays a nice second half to win it 89-85. For Dan Bell-Omedy, I'm Barry Conklin. Stay tuned for the Budweiser Thoroughbred Digest.